Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to do a quick video about example 2.4 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials using Ansys. Example 2.4 is very simple, just a rod loaded at one end and clamped at the other. We could calculate the elongation, stress, and strain using mechanics of materials formulas in a very short time, but we want to do it with Ansys to show how a model is set up, solved, and how to get the results with Ansys. In the preprocessor module, we start by selecting the element, LINK180, and we label it with type equals 1. This number is used later to associate this type of element to the section data and material properties. Now we define a section, labeled 1 to match the element type defined earlier. This section holds the cross-section area of the rod. Now we define a material, also labeled 1, to match the element type defined earlier. The Poisson's ratio is not needed for a link. In the APDL script, we are down to the shaded line, which is commented, because it is not needed. The modeling component helps us define the geometry of the part. Now we create a node. And we replicate it, 4 times. Now we create an element. And we replicate it, 3 times. In the solution module, we start by applying a displacement boundary condition on node 1 at the origin. And a force boundary condition on node 4 at the right end. Use the mouse wheel to shrink the display, and here's the force. And now we execute Ansys to solve the model. In the post-processor module, we start by listing the displacements at the nodes. As expected, nodal displacements increase from 0 at the origin to a maximum value at the loaded end. Now we plot the deformed geometry superposed to the undeformed one. Undeformed. Deformed. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe, and click the bell to get notified about new videos. You can find more details in the textbook, by following the link in the description. Thank you.